Hello, because we can't sit till you sit.
Oh, it's lovely.
Nice, isn't it?
I've never had to do so little for a big clap.
I know.
Fabulous.
We're going down that route today. I have a horrible feeling. What did you say before we started? You said, oh, isn't it nice? Look, you're not wearing a jacket, you see. Could you
toy with wearing a jacket? I toyed with wearing a jacket, and I thought all the bright young men will have lovely shirts and things.
Because this is the smartest we have seen
you.
It is the smartest.
It is probably the smartest you've seen. You get the odd woodlouse here and there crawling, you know, but I mean...
But what do they stick on you to make you look that horrible?
Just about everything. They put soda bread flour. They put latex. They put all sorts of awful substances, and then through my hair and everything. And they put Vaseline, which they colour up, and they put in my ears so that it drips out.
Oh.
That's the way. True, yeah.
That's a rather nice.
On a good day.
Exactly. On a good day. On a clear day.
I look like that first thing in the morning too.
Yeah.
And last thing at night.
And it's it's pretty gross, all right. Nobody come near me. Yeah. I don't blame them. I wouldn't come near myself.
Would you? But he is an endearing character. People do like him.
Why? This is the most extraordinary. Like, all my life, I tried to be young and handsome. No, well, it was a bit of a challenge, I know. But and then eventually, I played this desperate, drunken, old, geriatric, crazy man. Ooh. And everybody likes him. And particularly young children.
Really?
Small children all do Father Jack. Yeah. They're going around the place saying
the words
I'm not allowed to say at this hour of the day. But there you are, yeah.
Unbelievable the way the character's
taken. Small children,
off.
Particularly. Yeah.
Particularly small children. Yeah. Well, there won't be any watching today. It'll all be older adults. They're probably doing the impression too. Now, I did mention at the beginning that it's... Sorry?
It's half term.
Is it half term?
Yeah.
They get so many holidays nowadays. They really do.
Yes. It's half term break, isn't it? Yeah.
So they all be going, Father Jack, break, drink, drink, drink. Sorry,
they may use
I like
the other words.
You've got seven children, but none of them are at school.
No. Well, I've one, yes. One's still at school. She is 9 years younger than the next one. So you could put it down to absent-mindedness, you know?
I didn't want to know. I mentioned festive because a short while ago you brought out the 12 Days of Christmas.
I did, yeah.
As a record.
Yeah,
Comedy
Countdown. It was a spoof on the... Yeah, yeah. That actually charted once. It was on the top 20.
Really?
I was on Top of the Pops with that.
Were you?
And I got a letter from the Queen. Her Majesty the Queen.
Thank you.
Yes, I did indeed.
What did it say?
It said, we are commanded by Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth to inform you that your recording has given her much pleasure over the Christmas season, etc., etc., and signed by a lady-in-waiting. So there you are.
Isn't that nice?
Yeah.
Her Majesty gets great pleasure over the festive season.
Yeah.
I'm
it's
delighted.
Really nice. It was really lovely at the time. It's a long time ago. God knows she's had her worries and tragedies since.
Haven't we
all?
But now we've actually got the 12 Days of Chaos.
The 12 Days of Chaos, well, which is Michael O'Brien, my publisher of the O'Brien Press, he had this idea, he had this notion in his head for years that he wanted to make a book of this song. I said, you can't make a book of that. Imagine trying to talk your publisher out of taking your work. I said, you can't make a book of the lyric of a song. And he said, look, I'm a publisher, leave it up to me, you know. So eventually we got together and we chose a very close friend of mine, a great cartoonist, Terry Willers, who draws with a terrific kind of violence, and it's a great comedian and a very firm line. So we have the book, and we called it 12 Days of Chaos because really it's a kind of perennial thing, and that's a title bit of a longer shelf life. Mm. If it's Christmas, it's just going to be a Christmas thing.
Sure. Know? But what it is, it's a series of letters based on the 12th, on the first day of Christmas, my true love sent to me. Mm. And it's a love story.
Well, it's the implications of receiving things like 8 maids a-milking
on
Christmas Eve. Like, one doesn't quite need it, you know, or 11 lords a-leaping. Like, what would you do with that, like, you know? And the partridge in a pear tree.
Yes.
You know, it's droppings.
That's one of the easier ones to
do. It's droppings falling on your head while you're watching the telly. You know,
yes.
Things like that.
So in other words, she's sort of writing.
Nuala is the girlfriend.
Yeah.
And his name is Gubnut. Gubnut is an old Gaelic name. It's really a woman's name. And the feminine version of it is G-U-B-N-A-I-T. But there is actually a male version of it, which is G-U-B-N-E-T.
Right.
And I remember once doing a cabaret for a very prestigious firm, an after-dinner thing. And this woman crossed the floor with her lip quivering and the eyes flashing, and she said to me, you have ruined my life. And she was the managing director's wife. And I said, why? She said, my name is Gubnut. So I rubbished her socially. Well, unintentionally.
Dreadful thing there, really. But people will derive great pleasure, not only from the actual story, but they will derive it from the cartoons, too.
I think the cartoons are pretty good.
Yeah.
I think they're pretty good.
But you can't go any further, can you, than that? You have to stop at 12 Days of Chaos.
Well, I have... Yes, the only thing about it is that that was from a radio show that I did, and I have a whole lot of similar vehicles if Michael wants to publish the books. I have another one about an income tax inspector phoning somebody to know should he come down to this area. And the guy says, well, of course, you're very welcome, but if you do that, you'll have to come through the lower field, and we're poisoning there at the moment. It's very dangerous when we're poisoning there. If you don't believe me, you can ask the agriculture department. They lost an inspector coming through. And it goes on like that, you know, and becomes more chaotic too. So
excellent. Well, talking of chaos, we also get some more Father Ted's.
Yes, yes, we're going to do another 8, and my bank manager is only delirious. Yeah. And we'll have a turkey for Christmas because we're filming for a month down in Clare. Which is rather nice, and then I have Christmas off, really off, so it'll be a real kind of Dickensian Christmas with grandchildren crawling all over the place, and I don't care, just let it all happen. And Barbara and I both cook, so there's no martyr, there's nobody who's put upon. So, and then we're over to South Bank Studios for a couple of months to tape, January, February.
Can I just ask a quick question? Were you in the Italian affair with Michael Caine?
I was, indeed.
It was you?
Yes. You know the lovely story about Michael Caine?
No.
Where a very, very trendy West End theatre director rang him up. It's a true story. And he said, Mike, darling, he said, look, we'd so like you to do this piece. It's really, really, it's a bit dark, but you'd love it because I know you're such a good actor. Now, I know normally you chaps have paid telephone numbers, but if you'd make yourself available, he said, well, we'd pay your expenses and give you some sort of a salary and all that, you know. This time, Mike, he said, for art. And he said, last year I made 8 movies. I bought a Picasso. That is art.
Ladies and gentlemen, Frank Kelly. Oh, what's that? I'm looking at that one. Yeah.